Well, hello there. You're watching OffBeat Business TV and listening to OBBM Radio Dallas. I'm your host, Susan Hamilton, and I'm here with Richard Buck of Progressive Business Insights.
You're listening to the OffBeat Business Show, rebuilding American business influence locally, nationally, and abroad. Bringing you experienced insight for a strong, influential brand and successful life in business. Here's your host, Susan Hamilton.
Hello, Richard. Good to see you today.
Good to see you.
You know, it's really interesting the conversations that we've had over the last couple of months, Richard. You are doing some work and are responsible for some of the most interesting positioning statements for some pretty major companies. Would you tell our business owners a little bit more about what you're seeing in the marketplace from a corporate perspective when it came to positioning?
Well, I think the first thing that a business owner should understand is that short of starting the company, positioning is probably the most important thing that they'll do.
Well, that's probably true, but they may not know what that means. So give us a couple of examples of maybe some successes in your history and some of the things that you've been associated with.
Okay. Well, let me say first that positioning is not factually what your product or service or company is. Positioning is what you say it is. Now, that's not lying, but it's using the facts and finding the most persuasive way of expressing your product or your company. Does that make sense?
Oh, yes. Fascinating, yes.
Okay. We've worked with a great number of companies ranging from startups to, I think, 18 of the Fortune 100. But maybe people in Dallas would be interested in the fact that we did the bond issue campaign for the Dallas Museum of Art when they were over in Fair Park. And we found that a great city deserves a great art museum was an extremely strong idea. Now, the bond issue had failed the year before, but they wanted to try again. And using that positioning, we got a 58% positive vote, and the turnout was 50% higher than they forecast.
Isn't that something?
So that's what positioning can do if you have the right, most persuasive way of approaching things.
Excellent, especially during the election season. That makes me think we really need to look at that even a little bit differently. So fascinating, fascinating. You've had some interesting stories about brands that we're familiar with that asked you for advice on how to position themselves a little stronger.
Yeah, well, Tony Roma's restaurants, ultimate, you know, rib restaurant, they were looking for a positioning. And we found that meat so tender, it practically falls off the bone. And the ribs by which all other ribs are judged were
that's pretty strong.
Extremely strong ideas. So the agency used those to build a TV commercial. We also recommended to them that since they were introducing a rib line, that we take the different ribs and position them against different market segments to broaden their market. So there were the original baby back ribs, which were for the rib aficionados, you know. There was the beef rib, which, you know, was huge. And that was for the sort of blue-collar truckers kind of thing. And then there was the Danish baby back, which didn't have much meat on it. And that was for sort of the little old ladies who didn't want to get, you know, smudged up eating ribs. And then the St. Louis style was sort of for the family. So we did that, made that recommendation. The commercial was tested by a firm that only does finished commercials. And they had tested 138 restaurant commercials. And this was the most persuasive of the 138. We also got the second most persuasive for a pizza chain. So.
Yeah. No, that's fascinating. So the Dallas Dallas Symphony Orchestra and Tony Roma's ribs, that you've got some history here, and you've asked a lot of questions over your lifetime in marketing.
Yeah. Well, the interesting thing, you know, if you take the right positioning, it can build brand equity for you over the years. You don't want the agency kind of thing where you call the agency and say, well, I know what you did last year, what are you gonna do this year? A good positioning lasts for a long time. For example, Maxwell House Coffee.
Yes.
Is good to the last drop.
It is too, right?
They introduced that 80 years ago, and it's still good to the last drop. Now, when people think about that, they see a benefit in coffee that's good to the last drop. Maybe all coffee is good to the last drop. And I'm certain that nobody has gone to the last drop of Maxwell House and said, now I'm going to taste the last drop. So positioning is a matter of communicating an idea that sets you apart, sets you above others, and is highly persuasive.
I love that. And I love that you're having this conversation with me for our local business audience, especially local family businesses, who tend to use words like "we're the quality," right? They tend to use some words that are rather generic and kind of what I would call round, you know, without that straightforward approach, which it sounds like you're saying, if we can look at our brands a little bit differently and not just be in love with the logo, maybe really look at how does it matter to the consumer out there?
Yeah, and thinking about, you know, smaller businesses, mm-hmm. In the big corporations, they're hiring people and giving them titles like head of customer experience and, you know, digital marketing VP and things like that. And, you know, they report directly to the president. And, you know, president or the CEO is running around saying, what are we going to do about all this new technology? Well, the small businessman, you know, can't afford to hire high-priced people to tell them what to do about the new technology. So really, marketing hasn't changed. Only technology has changed. So people still communicate, you know, in TV and radio and billboards and whatever, and they always will. But they also communicate in the new technology, the digital world. And in that world, there's only two things to remember. One is you need a strong positioning to set you apart and above others. And two is you need media that will set yourself apart, because you can't outspend the big companies. Media like this, like Offbeat Business Media.
So. It's huge to be able to say that we are different, and we are, and this is what we are to you versus everyone else that does this type of work. Yeah. You're absolutely right. And we strive for that all the time. As a matter of fact, we enjoy a relationship with you for those reasons as well, because we have to keep our eyes open. We have to keep our ears to the ground to know, okay, what's that benefit to the consumer today, as we are in those early stages of building our brand. And yes. I think that's very important. But even if you've been around a while, folks, you really keep your ears open to what does that brand, because what you're really talking about is branding. You're talking about not your branding is not your logo and your colors. All those are aspects of what a customer might recognize with your brand. Your branding is what the consumer thinks of you and what how they view that. And they need to understand you. They need to have a certain idea of what it is you're doing so that they know how it relates to them.
Yes.
And so that's really what you bring to bear here is to have that conversation about positioning, because you're right. We are, otherwise we're all swimming in a red ocean. There is, if we look at everybody like it's competition, you're just, that's just not a successful way to advance your company and advance your bottom line. We have to look at each other like we are all part of this great big pool. There's, but what makes it different? What makes you different? Because there's a, the right customer for you. I hope you're enjoying this this conversation that I'm having with Richard Buck of Progressive Business Insights as much as I am. You're watching OBBM. You're listening to OBBM Radio Dallas and watching OffBeat Business TV. We're going to hear from our sponsors and we'll be right back.
The American business economy is positioned as it has never been before. Professional videography is a core element for attracting a higher level of engagement with the people group you need for significant impact. Now is your time to shine. My name is Bill Brock, owner of White Rock Films, and I invite you to a powerful opportunity in the marketplace, an opportunity to draw excited people to your events, an opportunity to showcase your ideas on infrastructure, an opportunity to become known as the industry authority and enjoy the associated benefits of a strong, influential brand. Video highlights, video teaches, video puts a resistant market at ease, and video stirs the hearts and imaginations of your allies and strategic client base. White Rock Films offers full audio, video production for businesses ready to embrace the future, handling your project with professionalism, experience, and polish unheard of in the industry. My name is Bill Brock, and White Rock Films wants your business. See us online at whiterockfilms.com.
Well, hello there. This is Susan Hamilton. Welcome back to OffBeat Business TV and OBBM Radio Dallas, where we are talking with Richard Buck of Progressive Business Insights, one of the masterminds behind some of the largest branding and positioning statements that you've heard over the years. And it's just so exciting to have your wealth of information here and that you're sharing with us today, because it's time we kind of look at things a little bit differently and recognize we got to position ourselves. Somebody else said early on in my career, you got to make your own celebrity. And that's that's really kind of the same thing, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, let me tell you how we do this.
Yes, sir.
Okay, because you know what I find is that the CEO of the company or the business owner has an idea of what he wants to say, and that may be a perfectly good idea, and it may be persuasive, but you don't know until you look at all of the possibilities. So what we do is we collect all the ideas from the people involved in the business. Then we do online searches to look at all the ways that competitors are talking about themselves, not just in the local market, but nationally or internationally. And then we have an ideation process and we come up with additional ideas. And as I told you at one point, we had one client that had 15 ideas of how they ought to be positioned, and we came up with another 400.
I mean, can you imagine? That's going to take some serious thought processes, friends. That's mind-boggling to me, but it's so necessary to really put that kind of thinking into your business. It's your livelihood.
Now, what we find is that consistently, out of any 60 good ideas, as I look at repeat studies, the most persuasive is 20 times as persuasive as the weakest. And that's not to say that, you know, competition or the company isn't using the weakest, is using the weakest, but it's to say that even if you find something two or three or four times as persuasive as what you might have said, that's worth doing.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. So what do we need to think about when we're looking at positioning? How can we do a better job of making sure we're positioned accurately in the marketplace?
Well, the first thing is to understand that there is something called positioning.
Yes, help us understand that a little bit more.
Yeah. And, you know, positioning, again, is what you say you are, regardless of what you factually are. Don't lie, but find the most persuasive way of talking about yourself. And once you've decided to do that, then you need research to tell you what is most persuasive. Because judgment, you know, experience gets you so far, but not all the way.
Right. There might be a language change that's necessary. There could be one word. It could be a sentence. There might be a color change. There's a bunch of different ways that this could impact how you.
Well, we found that out with the Dallas Art Museum bond issue campaign.
Yeah.
Because originally, when we tested different positioning alternatives, the one that finished strongest, most persuasive, was a first-class town shouldn't have a second-rate museum. And then we came back and did another layer and looked at alternative ways of saying that. And that's where we found a great city deserves a great art museum. Interesting, too, that the blue-collar guys were not quite as convinced that they needed a new art museum. But they said, you know, I didn't have the breaks, and I want my kid to have the breaks. And if a new art museum is what my kid needs, he or she is going to have it. And so then the agency took the great city deserves a great art museum line, put a picture of a kid that looks sort of sad, like they'd been deprived of an art museum. And then they used that in all their communications.
That is so interesting. So by using just a different tagline, if you will, just a different positioning like that, they were able to change and influence that community and also to support the community that they were wanting to serve. That's fascinating.
Yeah.
That's excellent. And of course, we all want that. We want to serve at our highest level.
You know, another thing that happens is the big corporations say, we need to develop a persona. We have to identify who our customer is,
our
demographically,
avatar, right?
And all,
yeah,
all that stuff. And with the technique that we use, you don't develop a persona. You find a persuasive positioning, and automatically you find out who that positioning appeals to. And so you can go with this positioning, and this is who you're going to get. But if you don't like that one, here's the number two, and that appeals to a different group. And gee, I like that, so, you know, we'll pursue that position.
It just looks like you've opened it. Well, it sounds to me like even with the ribs, right? So I can do this and I can do that and I can do that, but you don't know without doing some research and really looking at the market for those particular reasons.
Yeah. I mean, I developed a new technique that I haven't been able to sell to anyone because it's irrelevant.
Okay, Richard. All right. You got us interested. Help us understand that.
You know, I call it irrelevant segmentation.
Uh-huh.
And I was looking at my toe one day.
Yes.
And I said, toe, all research is based on what's logical and what's sensible. But what if the illogical is important? So I did a study with 1,500 people across the country and happened to ask them about food products and health and beauty aid products that they purchase. And then I asked some irrelevant questions, like, what is your political orientation? Are you Republican, a Democrat, an independent, or don't care? And found out an interesting thing. For just an example, that Democrats buy three times as much toothache medicine as Republicans.
That sounds like irrelevant information.
It's insane.
Yeah.
But so that's sort of a hidden opportunity that someday I'll find somebody that wants to explore that.
All right, Richard, but what did that have to do with your toe? So that's great. What can we do? What's the first question we should be asking ourselves when we are starting to question, hey, am I really reaching the people that I want to reach with my very best service?
Well, you know, you've got companies, you've got products, you've got services, you've got causes. You know, we just finished a study for the American Heart Association. And with any of these things, can even apply to promotions or events. You know, you look at an event and you say, what's the most productive event that I can field? Have I looked at all the alternatives? And so I'd say the first thing to ask yourself is, have I looked at enough alternatives, and do I understand how to do that?
And then you go out and reach them. So tell us a little bit about what it looks like to work with you, Richard, and your company, because you've been around a long time. You were saying you've got quite a few companies under your belt for helping get them just where they need to be.
Well, we've worked with Apple Computer and General Motors and Toyota and Pioneer Electronics and, you know, I could go on. Our first client was Blockbuster Video when they had seven stores. And they wanted a positioning. And so we looked at it and we found that the videos you want when you want them was the most powerful thing they could say. Their competition at that time was the mom and pop stores. And the demand for new releases drops off after the first week or two. So, you know, the mom and pop stores were sitting there saying, how many new releases can I afford to buy because I'm going to pay for them and then the demand's going to tail off? Where Blockbuster was financially well-backed, they were expanding. And so when the demand dropped off, they just take that excess merchandise and move it into new stores they were opening. So that enabled them to beat out the mom and pop stores. And they used that positioning for the first 5 years until they were over 2,500 stores. Mm.
So that's amazing. What does it look like to work with you? So what does it look like if a business owner wants to have some research done in this area?
Well, I mean, we're easy to work with.
Of course.
I mean, you know, we look at things this way, that there's the Jaguar or the Porsche, and there's the Chevrolet. And so when we look at a business, we try to look at the alternative ways that we can approach things. And some people need or want the Porsche, and some people can't afford the Porsche, but the Chevrolet will get them further ahead than they would have traveled.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I had one business startup where the owner walked in and said, I want to do research and find out if my idea is good or not. And I said, well, there's two ways to do it, the right way and the down and dirty way. And I thought, you know, he'd take the down and dirty way because that's where you are when you start a business. And he said, no, I want to do things right. And, you know, he spent a lot of money on that. But it was money well spent. But the average business owner were sensitive to the fact that we've got to find things they can afford.
Yeah, you got to be able to fit right in there and help them get where they want to be. And before we go, I just want you to understand that Richard's heart for the local business space is really sweet. You've had so much history with working with corporations, but these days a lot of the large corporates, they've got their own marketing, they've got their own in-house, and you're finding that as far as your own positioning, you want to get out here and share the things that you've learned over the years with the local small business community and help them achieve the greatness that you've seen in these other companies.
Yes, yes. And I love what you have.
Well, right. Thank you. And I look forward to a long relationship with you as we continue to get out here and support our local business owners, because that's a strong America, friends. Have you enjoyed this? I have had such a blast with you, Richard. Thank you for your time today.
Goodness,
yeah. So you're going to find all this information accompanying this video and accompanying this audio. So if you haven't downloaded your Offbeat Business app, make sure you do that. Have all of it in the palm of your hands. Until next time, this is Susan Hamilton with Offbeat Business TV and OBBM Radio Dallas.
You've been listening to the Offbeat Business Show. Find our lineup, podcast, magazine, event calendar, and sponsor information, even our membership directory, all available on the Offbeat Business app or at offbeatbusiness.com. Download the Offbeat Business app today. Take this for me, but I don't know.